Hello and welcome to this Affinity Publishing tutorial. I'm working my way through all the tools and windows in Affinity Publisher version 2. Today we are talking about the node tool, which is here on the left toolbar. When you hover over it, it says node tool and the keyboard shortcut for it is A. Now, what the node tool does is it allows you to manipulate nodes. It's kind of an interesting one, really, in desktop publishing software like Publisher is. You think of it more as being used in vectors, so we would expect fully to see it in Designer, but it's a little interesting to see it in desktop software, in my opinion. But what do I know? So let's show you what it does. So I have this object here that I drew with the Shape tool, and I'm going to start out by converting it to curves. Now, don't worry about that. It's just something I need to do to demonstrate the node tool for you. So what the node tool is it takes a vector object like this shape, and it allows you to manipulate the node. So I can grab any of these dots and move them around. It kind of turned our shape when we converted to curves into a dot to dot. And so let's actually take the fill off here for a moment, and I will put some stroke on this. And that kind of demonstrates a little bit better how we have these lines connected by dots. And that is what's making up this shape. So we can take any of these nodes, we can click on it, and you can see that that turns it blue. That means it's selected. And then we can click and hold, and we can drag this wherever we want. So if we wanted this to look like that, now we have got a different shape here. The other thing we can do is we could change this by adding or deleting nodes. So I'm going to select this, so now it's blue, hit the delete key on my keyboard, and now it is gone. I could also select that one, hit delete, and now it's gone. Now I could move this out a little bit. And now move this down a bit. Now it looks more like one of those Christmas stars. Like the star over the manger kind of star. Like that. So we can also add, and we can add just by double clicking anywhere on our shape, and that will add another node. So let's talk about a few other things related to nodes. And that is when we clicked on the node tool, we were on the move tool first. When we clicked to node, you can see that our options up here changed. Now, I am not going to go through every single option in this particular video, but I'm going to show you the most common and most useful ones. Kind of keep it at a beginner level. So what I want to look at first is this convert section. So you'll notice my nodes are all little square shapes. And this is a sharp node. So that is the first option here. It looks like kind of a open triangle. And what that means is where these points or dots in our dot to dot are, the line will make a sharp turn. Now, contrast that to when I select this dot here, up here on the top, and hit the second one, which is smooth. Now you can see that that rounded off the edge. It no longer comes to a sharp point. It comes to a rounded point. You can also see that the node has changed to a circle instead of a square. We also have another option when we have this rounded or smooth type of node. And when I click on it, you'll see there's these little barbells that now extend from it. So if I wanted to widen out this curve, I can drag on these little barbells. I can do all sorts of twisty things, tie it up in knots. And so that is what those barbells do. The further you stretch it out, the further it kind of mellows out the arc of this curve. Squish it in, and we get a sharper curvature here. And if you want it to be even, you'll need these barbells to be fairly even sized on each side. The last one here in the convert section is called smart. And basically what this does is it tries to predict what kind of node you would like, a sharp one or a smooth one. So if I have this smooth one here, let's make it smooth again, and I want to put a point here that's a smart one, it's going to say, there's a square one here, there's a smooth one here, but this is a little curved. Let's give this a smooth node. If I double click over here while on smart, it's giving me actually a sharp one because the adjacent ones are sharp. So it's trying to help you out, save you a few seconds of time by predicting what kind of node you might want to have. So let's go over to the action section now. And the first one here is break curve. So I'm going to click on this one here, it's selected blue, and break the curve. And now I can pull this apart and it is opened up. So I can take these two curves, select them both, and then join them again. And now they are back together. The other thing I can do is I can smooth the curve. So let's just put a few more little dots in here. We'll make them sharp. You can also hold shift and select multiple and change multiple at the same time. So, and let's just make things kind of jagged here. So finally, we can use the smooth tool in the actions here. It's the middle one. And so we can select multiple nodes by dragging, by holding our left mouse key and dragging over an area. Now I've selected multiple nodes. And this middle one here that says smooth curve, each time I click it, it's kind of changing the dots a little bit to try and help me auto smooth things that are a little bit rough. So you can just keep clicking on it until it is either doesn't do any more or it's as smooth as you would like it. It's not going to straighten out a line like this. It's basically going to take out like minor imperfections so that you don't have a jagged line. All right, so the node tool allows you to change shapes by moving them around. You can use the barbells to manipulate their shape, and you can switch them from having a rounded intersection. If we think of this as a dot to dot, each dot could come to have the line kind of come through it in a curved manner. Or with the square node, we can have the dot to dot change directions more sharply. We can delete nodes by selecting and hitting delete. We can add nodes by clicking anywhere on the line and just double clicking. And we can break the code, not the code, the curves, with the action menu, smooth the curve with the action menu, and we can join two pieces back together. So those are the basics of the node tool. There's more things that you can do with them. But for a beginner's video, this is the most important things to know. Thanks for watching.